Okay, so I'm Vikaas Sohal, and we're in my office at the University of California, San Francisco. And basically, I'm a scientist, and I run a lab that studies the neurobiology of psychiatric illnesses, and I'm also a psychiatrist and see patients. I think I've always been interested in science, you know. I think I've always had fun thinking about science, reading about science, talking about it, and always sort of imagined that science would be part of what I would end up doing in my life, whether it be as a scientist or maybe as an engineer or something like that. My dad is an engineer, so, you know, he's kind of in the field. You know, I think certainly my parents like to talk to me about science and teach me about science, and I would ask them questions, and I'd get books about science growing up. Then, you know, I think I went to college, and I knew I was interested in science and math, and I majored in applied math in college, and I took a lot of courses in diverse fields. So I took a lot of physics and computer science and engineering as well as math, and I also took some biology courses, and I really enjoyed them, and that kind of got me interested in neuroscience. Just talking to other students and taking classes, I kind of became more and more interested in that, and then started doing research when I was in college in neuroscience, and that sort of became the thing that I was most interested in. The big focus of the lab, you know, is really on trying to understand circuits in the brain, how they work, and how that functioning can be abnormal in the context of psychiatric disease. So we're really interested in, like, parts of the brain, how they all work together in order to generate kind of complex behavior, right? So I've always been interested in this general question of, like, you know, if you have a system, the system is made up of a bunch of parts. When you connect those parts and they start interacting with each other, they can do things that are unexpected or complicated. And that's certainly true of the brain. And that kind of complicated behavior is something that's really challenging to understand, but it obviously is at the heart of things like psychiatric illnesses. Trying to understand, you know, really circuits is what we do in the lab, and we try to do that in a couple of different ways. So, you know, we try to think about what are the properties of these circuits, how do cells talk to each other, you know, what controls if a cell is more or less excitable, and then we try to understand how does that change the behavior of a circuit as a whole, and then finally, how does that behavior of the circuit translate at the behavioral level for an animal trying to do a task or something like that. So we really try to connect up what's happening in terms of how cells interact to how that changes the function of circuits to how that changes the behavior of whole animals in ways that are relevant to psychiatric disease. So my role, you know, really as the principal investigator of the lab is to kind of, you know, supervise people, so meet with them and talk to them about what they're doing, what's working, what's not working, kind of think about ways to troubleshoot that. And then in addition to kind of working with people on a one-on-one basis to kind of think globally about, okay, what's the lab doing right now? How do we kind of summarize those results in a way that we generate a paper? And how do we think about the next set of projects? So what are we going to build on these projects to do in the next 5 to 10 years, right? It's fun, you know, working with people individually, and it's also fun to see the lab as a team, and I think that's something which I see more than maybe some of the individuals. People obviously have their own projects and are really engrossed in their projects, and there's times when they're working with everyone else in the lab, but even when they're working, you know, with 2 or 3 other people in the lab, there's very few times when they're working it with everybody at one time. So I can kind of see the big picture of the lab in a way that sometimes I think is harder for individual people to see and is exciting, and I'm always trying to transmit that to people in the lab because I think that when you see the big picture, it is really exciting. It might, you know, your individual project might have frustrations and there might be things that aren't working as the way you'd hope they'd work. But when you think about that individual project as part of the overall direction of the lab, you see that, oh yeah, even though this thing didn't work, I still was able to figure out these problems and that helped somebody else. And by helping someone else, we actually got insight into the bigger picture of what's going on.